everyone, my name is Angel Tai. Today the title of my presentation is Malaysia's Breakthrough in Modern Actinobacteria Drug Discovery Research. This presentation is based on a paper published in the journal called Progress in Microbes and Molecular Biology. The link for the full paper will be available in the description box below. What is actinobacteria? Within the bacteria domain, the phylum Actinobacteria represents one of the largest taxonomic units among 18 major lineages, comprising 6 classes. Generally, Actinobacteria is the largest class, and it can be characterized into 2 groups, namely Streptomyces, which is the dominant genus, and non-Streptomyces, also known as rare Actinobacteria. Streptomyces and rare Actinobacteria are important sources of novel bioactive secondary metabolites, which leads us to the term Mod Actino. Mod Actino stands for Modern Actinobacteria, and this term has been coined by Malaysian researcher Professor Dr. Lee Leng Han to define Actinobacteria with modern applications. Briefly, this term applies to actinobacteria that synthesize natural products with new bioactivities. Actinobacteria that produce approved drugs and have been subjected to drug repurposing efforts. And lastly, known or novel actinobacteria obtained from unique environments. What are these unique environments? They include hot springs, deserts, the Arctic and Antarctic regions, caves, and most importantly in relation to Malaysia, it is the mangrove forest, where numerous novel and bioactive Streptomyces species had been isolated. In this table, we can see several novel Streptomyces species and novel rare Actinobacteria species that had been discovered in Malaysia, particularly from the mangrove soil of Tanjung Lumpur, Pahang and Kuching, Sarawak. The Mod Actino species discovered in Malaysia have vast bioactive properties, which includes anti-MRSA, antimicrobial, anti-cancer, antioxidant, antifungal, and anti-malarial. In this presentation, I will only be discussing on the anti-MRSA, antimicrobial properties. Streptomyces is the largest antibiotic-producing genus that can produce antibiotics of different classes. However, the improper use of antibiotics has led to an issue with multi-drug-resistant pathogens, including the methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. This poses significant challenge to the healthcare system because MRSA is non-susceptible to conventional antibiotic therapy, which results in life-threatening infections. In this presentation, the novel Streptomyces species exhibiting anti-MRSA activity that will be discussed are MUSC-135T, SUK25 and MUSC-125. Streptomyces pluripotens MUSC-135T was isolated from the mangrove soil of Tanjung Lumpur. It exhibited broad-spectrum bacteriocid activity against several pathogens, and the strongest antibacterial activity was against the MRSA. On the other hand, Streptomyces species SUK25 was isolated from medicinal plants in Malay Peninsula. Results showed that the Streptomyces species SUK25 crude extracts exerted antimicrobial activity against several MRSA strains. In fact, it showed more potent inhibition activity than the vancomycin control. Streptomyces species MUSC-125, also isolated from the mangrove soil of Tanjung Lumpur, had shown promising anti-MRSA and anti-biofilm compounds. This strain displayed a high 16S rRNA sequence similarity with Streptomyces pluripotens MUSC-135T, Streptomyces cinereospinus, and Streptomyces mexicanus. The antibiofilm experiment demonstrated that the methanolic extract of Streptomyces species MUSC-125 was effective to inhibit biofilm formation by MRSA at 1/8 times MIC, which was the lowest concentration tested. Besides, Streptomyces species MUSC-125 possessed the biosynthetic gene clusters encoding for polyketide synthase type 1 and type 2. Hence, Streptomyces species MUSC125 is a potential producer of cryptic polyketides that can be valuable therapeutic agents. In conclusion, nature is a treasure chest for novel and biologically active actinobacteria discovery. More actino strains from Malaysia has potential to produce medically valuable bioactive metabolites that could be further isolated and developed into useful drugs. These are my references. Thank you everyone for your kind attention in listening to my presentation. I would also like to thank the IMDF Organizing Committee for providing me the opportunity to present in such prestigious event. Thank you.